So I told myself I wanted to kind of start using small videos to explain and talk about comments and stuff, kind of like TikTok, where you can place a comment and then you can talk about the comment and whatnot in your video. Kind of want to do the same thing here. It's not as easy to do, but we're going to recreate it a little bit. But I got a comment from somebody here talking about that last video that I made about the shoulders and whatnot. And this isn't to call them out or anything. It's just to make sure everybody's on the same page and everybody understands. And their comment was talking about how the shoulder has to get out of the way. And if you're not making your shoulder collapse back or doing something with your shoulder, then you're not creating power. And where the misconception here is this isn't baseball. You know, like in baseball, it was about tucking the glove arm, tuck the glove arm, pull your shoulder back, and then the right shoulder comes through. That's one thing when you're actually throwing a ball with your shoulder. In bowling, you're not trying to throw the ball with your shoulder. You're letting momentum swing the ball. Your shoulder, your bowling shoulder, should just be basically like an axle or whatever, you know, just a swinging pendulum. That should just be something that it's hanging on. What's the word I'm looking for? What would that be? I know you guys are going to tell me in the comments below, so let me know in the comments below what the word I'm looking for. But you know what I'm talking about, where it's just hanging there and the weight of the ball and your feet create the momentum to create everything else. That's the ideal swing. The ideal swing is to use as very little muscle as possible and not having your non-bowling shoulder affect your shot. So with the non-bowling shoulder, when that shuts down, it makes you go forward with this shoulder, and then you have no choice. Your arm automatically goes around to the top side of the ball. The power comes from your legs by creating good position, lower stance, lower knee bend, and getting your body into a good spine tilt. You can create leverage, and then you can get your hand into the proper spot. The power comes from your legs and wrist action. If you're talking ball speed, still comes just from your legs. Your legs have to move faster, so the ball swings faster in the swing to create more momentum. Now, I know some people use muscle and whatnot, and you may think that you create power by using your left shoulder and not keeping the shoulder quiet, but I'm telling you 150,000% that if you're doing it, you better practice an awful lot, otherwise you're gonna have a lot of inconsistencies. So for those of you that are watching and seeing these comments, I'm over exaggerating the idea of keeping the arm out in front, like you're gonna give yourself a high five. That's just an over exaggeration tool. That's what you think about. That's your process of practicing in order to quiet this shoulder down. We have to create new muscle memory. And the only way to do that is to over exaggerate. Because if we're just doing things the same way, I'm getting a phone call, sorry. If we're just doing things the exact same way and we don't feel any different, then we're not making any change. So you have to over exaggerate it. Because those of you that you're gonna try to make the change and you're just gonna go out and you're gonna feel like your arm's out here when it's still way behind you. So all the coaches that teach the arm out here, they're teaching to keep the arm quiet to the side. They're not teaching you to whip it back behind you. Most coaches understand and know better that if that arm goes back behind you, you're causing problems with the bowling arm. So just keep this in mind. Commenter, not here to call you out, just here to correct some things and make sure people are on the same page and understand what's going on. So there you go, guys. I hope this helps. Until next time, we'll see you later.